Good evening, Netscape Navigators. I'm here to talk to you today about the most heinous crime of all, the greatest cringe known to man, the crime of being horny on Maine. Did you know that there are a lot of horny people online? I know, and it's terrible. In the real world, people are ashamed, as they should be, of their horniness. They keep it hidden, away from prying eyes, only letting it out when the sun goes down or behind closed doors, like good, respectful citizens. But on the internet, this is unfortunately not the case. Like the horniness, the cringe is everywhere. It's actually quite interesting when you look at it from afar. You see, people online are anonymous, and one of the benefits of being anonymous is there aren't any really real repercussions for acting in any which way you desire. A lot of this results in people just becoming huge assholes with opinions online, and other results end up with, reply guys, people who are just thirsting after everyone in the comments. Many people see horniness as a detrimental thing. It tends to lead to some very debaucherous attitudes and not-so-keen thinking is the nicer way of putting it. Online, they tend to just pop up everywhere, so there's no real getting away from them. So even if it's something that you're actually into, it gets kind of tired very, very quickly. So one of the rules of the internet has kind of become no horny on Maine. It's something that's become more and more kind of accept it. You keep that side of yourself somewhere else, somewhere kind of quarantined, far away from the rest of us decent human beings. I think a big part of the reason why people expect you to do this is, well, people on the internet are very different, and that becomes no more apparent when you start to consider all the different things that turn people on. There are so many things that turn on so many people, it's impossible to keep track of, and on top of that, it just hits you out of nowhere. You're never ready for the things that turn people on. You think you're watching a video that has no real sexual nature to it, and yet somebody will find some way to be turned on by it. Somehow. Horny crimes will always be committed. The only tool we have in our power to deal with this is to shame the person, to point at them, to accuse them, and to remind them that they are, in fact, being a horny person. And you may be saying to yourself, what's wrong with being horny? Well, nothing, you know. Depending on how you go about doing the horny. And you may go about your horniness in one way, but the crimes of the horny are vast. The horny are irrational. The horny are rude. The horny are dramatic. And the horny are very temperamental. Do not anger the horny, for they will lash out at you. They are unpredictable and dangerous. Also, they can strike at any time. You might just be enjoying a very nice food video, and then all of a sudden somebody is posting pictures that are just... It's like you're having dinner and then all of a sudden somebody just flashes you. Depending on the person who's doing it, it might be okay. But more than likely, no. No, it is not okay. I know when we all sit down and think about it, being horny is the worst thing ever. Yes, they have ruined lives everywhere. Yes, being horny is terrible and everyone should be ashamed of it. But maybe the internet is the best place for the horny to be. Let me defend those who stand accused of being horny for just one moment. It might benefit us to sort of explore these horny people and to understand further why they horny and why they horny so much on the internet. It's pretty fortunate that we don't see as many horny people out in public as we do on the internet. Imagine having dinner and all of a sudden some person runs up and flashes you and it lets you know just how turned on they are right now. That is a literal crime. That is something you can go to jail for. But on the internet, it's something that's just kind of commonly accepted. Even if you can punish somebody for doing so, nothing really gonna stop them from just coming back with another account and doing the same thing again. And the worst part about this is, I don't think the horny people are going away. You kind of see on the internet, people have sort of just accepted it. Yes, there's a lot of good shaming going around, as they well deserve, but at the same time, it's not exactly effective. Horny people gonna horny. And in a lot of cases, I think the reason so many horny people are so open about their horniness is because while a lot of people hate the horny, there are other horny people that they can kind of attract. It's how they find like-minded people and build like-minded communities. You know, little cesspools of horniness where they can all go congregate and discuss their sin. And sometimes, this leads to friendship in a really disgusting and perverted way that's actually kind of wholesome. I mean, yes, it's deviant. Yes, they're perverts. Yes, they're simps. But at the same time, I don't think shaming these people is gonna make them any less horny. It might kind of chase them off for a little bit, or maybe at best they stop being so public about it. But these people are gonna feel what they're gonna feel, and they're gonna like what they're gonna like. To be horny is to be cringe, and to be cringe is to suffer. But I may posit that this suffering, the lead cause of it, is loneliness. and feeling kind of ashamed and weird for, you know, being horny. And I think this might be the reason why so many people choose to be horny on Maine. It's due to loneliness. It's trying to find someone to connect with. And that's kind of the main reason why the internet was invented. It was to connect to people. And yes, you may not want to connect to the horny person. I completely understand. But when you see horny people online, they are utilizing the internet in a way that was meant to be utilized. They're trying to find a connection. And as perverse and horrible as that connection may be, it's something that's needed. It can be really sad to be horny and alone. Sometimes having someone else to go through that horniness with is kinda nice. Not that I would ever know what that feels like, ever, at all. And how about you, internet? Have you ever experienced a cringy moment where you look back and you go, oh God, what was wrong with me? If you're brave, scroll down. If not, God be with you. Because the horny people, they're everywhere. That's it. This is a weird one. Have a good night, Netscape Navigators.